This is the data Victor downloaded. So what we thought were budget numbers is actually a numerical representation of a virus genome.
That makes sense to you. No.
It's simple. DNA is just a code. When we sequence it, we figure out what the code is, and then we store it as a series of numbers.
Do you remember Carol? She's a lab tech at the VA.
Infectious Disease Program Office. What's your name, cutie?
Tobias. I'm old enough to be your father.
I asked Carol to try to help me ID which virus's genome belongs to.
Ebola variant, RUV-76. The usual stuff. You bleed from every orifice, it disintegrates your organs, and then you die.
From numbers?
Well, that's all these were 10 years ago when they were sequenced and stored and forgotten in some warehouse.
But times have changed. It's now possible to build a synthetic virus from scratch using a numerical recipe just like this and gene sequences you can get online.
I keep saying it. Things were better before the internet.
How bad?
It's bad, but the good news is this variant is only spread by touch, and it's too virulent to cause a pandemic.
Which is a nice way of saying people die too quickly to spread the disease too far.
Doesn't make sense, kids. Victor strike you as a terrorist?
No.
I mean, he's a paper pusher, not a mass murderer. Embezzlement, I'll buy.
Maybe this is his big score. I mean, if terrorism was his goal, there were way deadlier viruses to steal in this database.
This virus is tactical. It would make the perfect weapon.
It'd be worth millions if he found the right buyer.
He doesn't want to use it.
He wants to sell it.
But first he has to build it. And there's only one place in the area that has the ability to create man-made viruses.